make sure you know where your off button is.
If you're offended,
you'd keep your mouth shut if you knew it was good for you, buddy.
That's your sweet spot right there.
Who are these sick people?
Got enough time? All the sweethearts gone? They can't complain. Let's go.
We interrupt this program with a special bulletin. America is now under martial law. All constitutional rights have been suspended. Stay in your home. Do not attempt to contact loved ones, insurance agents, or attorneys. Shut up. Do not attempt to think or depression may occur. Stay in your home. Curfew is at 7 p.m. sharp after work. Anyone caught outside the gates of their subdivision sectors after curfew will be shot. Remain calm. Do not panic. Your neighborhood watch officer will be by to collect urine samples in the morning. Anyone caught interfering with the collection of urine samples will be shot. Stay in your home. Remain calm. The number one enemy of progress is questions. National security is more important than individual will. All sports broadcasts will proceed as normal. No more than two people may gather anywhere without permission. Use only the drugs prescribed by your boss or supervisor. Shut up! Be happy! Obey all orders without question. The comfort you've demanded is now mandatory. Be happy! At last, everything is done for you.
Rolling across the picket line. Lay down, G.I. Lay down, G.I. We saw it all through the 20th century. And now in the 21st century, it's time to stand up and realize that we should not allow ourselves to be crammed into this rat maze. We should not submit to dehumanization.
I don't know about you, but I'm concerned with what's happening in this world.
I'm concerned with the structure. I'm concerned with the systems of control. Those that control my life and those that seek to control it even more. I want freedom! That's what I want! And that's what they should want!
It's up to each and every one of you to turn with some of the greed, the hatred, the envy, and yes, the insecurities.
Because that is the central mode of control. Make us feel pathetic, small, so we'll willingly give up our sovereignty, our liberty, our destiny. We have got to realize that we're being conditioned on a mass scale. Start challenging this corporate slave state.
The 21st century is going to be a new century. Not the century of slavery, not the century of lies and issues of no significance, and classism, and statism, and all the rest of the modes of control. It's going to be the age of humankind standing up for something pure and something right.
What a bunch of garbage, liberal, Democrat, conservative, Republican. It's all there to control you, two sides of the same coin.
Two management teams bidding for control, the CEO job of Slavery Incorporated. The truth is out there in front of you, but they lay out this buffet of lies. I'm sick of it, and I'm not going to take a bite out of it. See, you got me?
Resistance is not futile. We're going to win this thing.
Humankind is too good. We're not a bunch of underachievers. We're going to stand up, and we're going to be human beings. We're going to get fired up about the real things, the things that matter. Creativity and the dynamic human spirit that refuses to submit. Well, that's it. That's all I got to say. Continue court.
brighter note.
Commercial break.
The government has now banned the carrying of spears.
Stop about every 1,000 miles, ain't asking too much, is it?
You might wish to stay on and listen.
It was a place where everything was legal.
I met this woman.
So if you're looking for emotional satisfaction, my advice to you is seek professional help.
Thank you for joining us live on the air.
My pleasure.
One Nation under God has turned into one nation under the influence of one drug. Television, the drug of a nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation on television. The drug of a nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation. TV, its satellite links are United States of unconsciousness. Apathetic, therapeutic, and extremely addictive. The methadone metronome, pumping out 150 channels 24 hours a day. You can flip through all of them, and still there's nothing worth watching. TV is the reason why less than 10% of our nation reads books daily. Why most people think Central America means Kansas. Socialism means un-American, and apartheid is the new headache remedy. Absorbed in this world, it's so hard to find us. It shapes our minds the most. Maybe the mother of our nation should remind us that we're sitting too close to the television. The drug of a nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation on television. The drug of the nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation. TV is a stomping ground for political candidates, where bears in the woods are chased by Grecian formulated bald eagles. TV is mechanized politics, remote control over the masses, co-sponsored by environmentally safe gases. Watch for the PBS special. It's a perpetuation of the two-party system, where image takes precedence over wisdom, where soundbite politics are served to the fast food culture, where straight teeth in your mouth are more important than the words that come out of it. Race baiting is the way to get selected. Will he Horton or will he not get elected on television? The drug of a nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation on television. The drug of a nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation.
On the screen is an address where you can mail your tithe offering or gift of love.
Okay, got the idea? All right, now let's pass it.
Is it the reflector or the director? Does it imitate us or do we imitate it? Because a child watches 1,500 murders before he's 12 years old. And then we wonder why we created a Jason generation that learns to laugh rather than abhor the whore. TV is a place where armchair generals and quarterbacks can experience firsthand the excitement of video warfare as the theme song is sung in the background. Sugar-sweet sitcoms that leave us with a bad actor taste, while pop stars metamorphosize into soda pop stars. You saw the video, you heard the soundtrack. Well, now go buy the soft drink. Well, the only cola that I support would be a union COLA cost of living allowance on television. The drug of the nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation on television. The drug of the nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation. Back again, new and improved, we return to our irregularly programmed schedule, hidden cleverly between heavy-breasted beer and car commercials. CNN, ESPN, ABC, BCB, TNT, but mostly BS, where oxymoronic language, like virtually spotless, fresh, frozen, light, yet filling, and military intelligence have become standard. TV is a place where phrases are redefined, like recession to necessary downturn, crude oil on a beach to moose, civilian death to collateral damages, and being killed by your own army is now called friendly fire. TV is a place where the pursuit of happiness has become the pursuit of trivia, where toothpaste and cars have become sex objects, where imagination is sucked out of children by a cathode ray nipple. TV is the only wet nurse that would create a cripple. Television, the drug of a nation, breeding ignorance, feeding radiation. On television, the drug of a nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation. On television, the drug of the nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation. On television, the drug of the nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation.
At last, yes? I met your mother on the way to work, yes? She gave me the key. She says something about a pain somewhere, hence not at school, yes?
A rather intolerable pain in the head, brother, sir. I think it should be clear by this after lunch.
Or certainly by this evening, yes. The evening's the great time, isn't it, Alex boy?
Cup of the old chai, sir?
No time, yes. Sit.
To what do I owe this extreme pleasure, sir? Anything wrong, sir?
Wrong? Why should you think of anything being wrong? Have you been doing something you shouldn't? Yes?
It's just a manner of speech, sir.
Yes, well, it's just a manner of speech from your post-corrective advisor to you that you watch out, little Alex, because next time it's not going to be the corrective school anymore. Next time it's going to be the bawdy place and all my work ruined. If you've no respect for your horrible self, you at least might have some for me, who've sweated over you. A big black mark, I tell you, for everyone we don't reclaim. A confession of failure for every one of you who ends up in the stripy hole.
I've been doing nothing I shouldn't, sir. The Millicents have nothing on me, brother. Sir, I mean.
This is a very old story. If you don't understand something, then you attack it. You call it weird or occult. And you try to destroy it. Well, the person who is leading the attack is usually someone who is on very shaky moral ground himself. He's unsure of himself, and so he lashes out in a paranoid way against those of us who have ascended to a higher plane of consciousness and awareness. Well, we'll survive this. We always have in the past. And when Mr. Reese loses his anger and his fear, we invite him to join us in spreading our message of love and profit. Thank you very much.